Anytime Chief Mam hears this, he feels disappointed, he feels worried. When he calls and talks to me, it's like, well, these are the people that they hail praises on me. They show me great respect anytime, but my grandchildren are in their schools, and my grandchildren are not treated well. I mean, he feels, yeah, but meek as he is, the chief man will never tell you, go and shout, go and do that, but that he feels disappointed. And I feel disappointed. If truly, I have been a teacher, and I understand the psychological implications of this. Any child you mistreat in the, within the school system, the psychological impact on his being as he grows further, just like a child who is abused in the house for too long, or a child who is exposed to abuse, he sees his father slapping his mother, kicking his mother with foot, that child will grow to become a violent person when he gets married. The same thing, any child who is mistreated, treated with indignity, disrespect, his rights are abused, that child will grow never to see anything wrong with abuse of human rights.
Right.
And I think that as teachers, even within the mission, we are told that compassion is something that we uphold. And I find a contradiction when Muslim children are in Christian schools, and Christians who uphold the virtue of compassion and respect for human dignity will not be able to look at within the frame of their discipline to also respect the diversity in it and say, oh, these are Muslim children. We are happy. We are making contributions into their lives.